Hi everyone, this is Anka Metcalf with TradeOutloud.com. Welcome to the weekly outlook for the week starting with October 29th. It is right after the close right now at the time of the recording. It is Friday 10:26. It is 4 p.m. Eastern time. The stock market just closed. We have about 15 minutes left until the first break in the futures, and then the market is going to close. We're going to begin with the E-mini S&P. A lot of damage has been done to the price, to the charts. For the first time this week, we have violated the 50 SMA. On the weekly chart, we have seen no reaction off of this level, and we continue to slice through each and every single level of support that we had from the weekly chart. We have had a really advanced decline, and at this point, we have erased everything that we have gained from January. So I'm going to put my cursor very quickly over this January, first week of January. This is January 1st. Okay, and this is January 1st bar, and you can see that right now 2699, in fact 2700 was the back then it was resistance, and then it broke through that resistance. We had a really nice rally for about a month rally until the volatility hit, and it took the price back down to the 50 SMA, rotated back up, revisiting, establishing a new higher low, and then higher lows throughout the month of October. October came in with a lot of volatility and took the price back down, erasing the gains for the E-mini S&P, taking the price back down into this support level right here. We also have room to decline, so this may not be this may not be the low, as we still have a lot of room for a correction. First target is going to be into this prior pivot low from April 30th at 2590, and then we still have two more zones of support here. This is the 2550, and the next zone right here is into the 2505. October is known as being one of the most volatile months, and obviously many traders have not seen this kind of volatility in the market that literally has continued for more than 3 weeks. So the first decline came, let me just pick up my cursor very quickly here. All right, thank you. So first we started here on October 1st, and we had a reversal, and we came right into the support level, and the support level was holding the highs from January 29th. We didn't manage to hold this low, and we actually sliced through this 10 exponential moving average and through this prior pivot high, and we accelerated very quickly to this 50 SMA. Again, here we had a quick reaction, brief reaction, and then the price came back down. So again, things are looking very, very choppy. I'm gonna zoom in to the daily charts to show you that we're trading into this chop. The price is well below the 200 simple moving average. The fact that we're not yet, and we cannot talk about a confirmed downtrend, is because we only have a top and one lower high, and only one lower low right here. But if the price, and if we should get a pop into next week, into possibly into the 2730 to 2750 zone, and if we're going to get a rotation back to the downside, this is going to be the confirmation that we have entered an established downtrending market from the daily chart. So until then, we are still left with a lot of volatility. For day trading, it has been a very challenging and impossible environment, not unless you have very deep pockets. Definitely not worth risking. So I have seen stops that were ranging between 30 points and 50 points in NASDAQ, stops in the E-mini S&P on the time frames that I trade, the 5 minute charts, day trading those time frames, and I see that the stops are incredibly wide, 7 to 10 point stops in ES, 100 points to 80 point stops, lower time frames on a 2 minute or a 5 minute in the E-mini Dow, and same goes for Russell about 7 points or 8 points or so. So it has been a very hard market this week and even last week for day traders, and I think that if you are a day trader, have patience and do not risk your hard-earned money into this market, because it's definitely not worth it. Right now, we're left with pretty neutral bar because we are zipping up a little bit here, and we zipped up into the close. But again, this is an indecision candle. I think that 2700 is going to be a big barrier. This is going to represent minor resistance moving forward. And even if the price is going to accelerate into the 2700 going into early week or throughout the week, this can be a turnaround point, and we can rotate back to the downside below 2650 and below this point, and even revisiting some of these lows that were visited late spring. No action as so far. This is not any action of buying the dip, nothing conducive of that sort. I just want to highlight one thing, that the S&P is approaching very, very fast the 89 simple moving average, and that is at 2610. So 2610 can be the potential buying, the rotating point, that reversal, strong reversal zone. And that is, again, coinciding with support from the volatility that we have received back in January. All right, let's move on to the M&E Dow. The M&E Dow has pretty much the same structure I had drawn earlier this week. The Fibs from this prior pivot low in June, end of June, into the high that we had on October 3rd. And you can see that here there was a tug of war at the 61.8% level. We also had support from this 200 SMA. It was a rising 200 SMA at the time, and we have been trying to rotate a little bit higher. We reached the 38.2, and then the price got rejected. So the price meandered between the 61.8% and the 50%, and then it tried to push a little bit higher, got rejected, and just sliced through the 61.8%. And right now it's trading at the last shelf of support. Anything that is below the 24,600 level is extremely bearish. Mostly could trigger a sell cone that can take the price much lower into the 24,000. So you could see that there's a really, really wide trade will avoid into the next support level into the M&E Dow as well. Let's take a quick look at NASDAQ, and I'm going to bring the weekly chart for NASDAQ as well. You can see that NASDAQ also violated the 50 SMA. And it sliced through it. It just hovered. It just established a new support level into today. Because actually today, Friday, 10/26, right now, we just made a new low. And the new low for NASDAQ is 6734.25. This is the new support level. We're trading into a continuation of a 4 hour, and we're really trying to hold this pivoting low area. This is the 4 hour bar. We have accelerated, tapped onto the 20 simple moving average, moved a little bit higher, challenging these two candle highs right here. And then we have shifted into a more bearish tone, trying to challenge. We have actually triggered a 1 hour sell, and we were trading into the configuration of an hourly sell, and then we're trying to reverse here. So since establishing the new low at the 6734, we made a higher low and a higher low right here. So it is very, very hard, to predict what's going to happen next in the market. Obviously, we can see strong downtrends and biases in the market for longs and for shorts. Right now, NASDAQ on the daily chart has closed, and we have a doji bar, an indecision bar right here. Over 7,000, I would look more optimistic, even though it is far away from this point. I will look more into try to recoup back into possible a push for the day traders, try to push back up into the 70-80 zone. And then if the price is going to get rejected at this point, I think we may see still lows of 6,500, because this is the area that this is the next support level from the weekly charts. And also at this, I don't have this moving average here on this chart, but I use it on my charting system. And I have another support level from the 89 simple moving average at 6,500. So this is going to be the next move, possibly if we get hit again for the downside. This is going to be the next move down for NASDAQ. Russell, very choppy. It has been one of the weakest index. And this is starting September 3rd. So the other indices like the E-mini Dow, E-mini S&P, and NASDAQ rotated on October 3rd. So a month later, a month after Russell has signaled the first sell in the market. Russell has been into a continuous sell since September 3rd, and it has been continuing to trade lower. As you can see, the weekly chart still has, although reaching an area of support, and this area of support is coming from November 2017, just tapped onto that support level, just bounced slightly. It is still trading. It has triggered the four-hour reversal. However, it is still having tons of resistance at the 1510 zone. So the more the price presses against 1500, and we're going to get the selling pressure at 1500, we may still have a move back to the lows of 1450. And perhaps as the target that I see into Russell may be into the 1400 or even 1430. That's what I see for the target. If we get a reversal in the upcoming days, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and going into Wednesday, the price needs to prove a lot. So I need to see at least a series of higher highs and higher lows on the 1 hour chart to get back into confidence and try to subside some of the volatility that has been created. A lot of panic, a lot of fear, a lot of freeze happening in the market right now. There are a lot of traders that have lost their trading accounts, trading recklessly in this market. So if you have a small account, or if you're a small account holder or a medium account holder, this market is not for you, and it's not particularly for day traders, not unless you're using no stops, okay? And that is quite impossible, because you need to use the predetermined risk when you're initiating trades. Let's review oil. And oil has bounced really nicely off the 50 simple moving average. This is the weekly chart, so it got a little bit of bounce. If into the following week we're going to break above $70, we're going to try to zip back up into the $75 in the upcoming days or weeks, probably in a week or so, but it all depends on price. So let's move on to the daily chart. The daily chart is challenging this prior pivot high. I am into oil long. My risk for this trade is below 65.70. I'm looking for further targets that are into $68. $67.80 was my first target. $68 and $68.80. So it's about a dollar away from where the price is trading right now. Now, the confusion comes from the fact that you see oil downtrending here, and you can see the reversal coming into the support level, trying to shift direction back to the upside, and then the price got rejected. So you can see the velocity that took the price lower. We have 1-2 bar accelerator run to the downside, very shallow pullback again, very similar to what we had here on February 8th and 9th. And here we had this shallow pullback, move back down, very shallow pullback as well here. So we had a bear flag formation as well here. So this was the first bear flag formation. This was the second bear flag formation. Now on this bear flag formation, things were looking a little bit differently, because we needed to have a trigger over $70 that never came in. So right now we have the next accelerated bar to the downside, back into the support level. What I like about oil here is that the weekly chart respected this 50 SMA. We got an immediate response off that 50 SMA. And that's what I did on my trade. So that's what I saw. And moving forward to the daily chart, we have erased yesterday's high, and we're trading in a higher directional bias. Like I said, I'm gonna be looking for targets into 68 and 68.50, 68.80 would be my at most target. And at this point, I'm going to do a diligent trail, being in the money right now. I'm going to do a diligent trail. I'm going to be watching it in the overnight, and actually to see how it opens on Sunday. I'm going to take a look at Sunday, probably around 9:30 or 10 o'clock. What is different now than the buy off this low or this lower? First off, we got the trigger here. However, this did not respect any kind of technical, was not a technical bounce, so it violated any kind of support zone, so I didn't like it as a support zone here. And then here, I would have liked the reversal over 70, but 70 never occurred, so here, it fit right into my pattern. It had a decent pullback on the weekly chart on a technical zone, so that's why I initiated. Moving forward, like I said, as long as we're holding the 67.50 zone, 67.40 is the new support level that has been established into the New York trading session on Friday. As long as we hold that support level, we can still accelerate higher. So I really like oil to hold in this area. All right, let's take a quick look at gold. And gold has been holding our support level of 1220. In fact, I had a hard stop into the 1219 zone. It is trying to inch a little bit higher, but it is trying to break out, and then it just fizzles out, and then it just enters back into the sideways grind. Again, we have achieved one of the targets today. 140 actually was the target today. I would have liked gold to hold the 140 into 141, but it came back into the median zone of 1226, and that is based on an hourly chart. It's just holding this median level. Now, what I do like is that today, and what this week brought for gold is that it really managed to break through this 200 SMA and hasn't done that. It hasn't been trading above the 200 SMA since July, since mid-July. So this is the first time since mid-July, since it's creeping up a little bit here. So I'm still going to let it trade. Again, I think it's a highly emotional trade, but it looks very good for a continuation higher. One chart in particular has drawn my attention for being overly active, and this is heating oil. I love heating oil the way it is setting up. In fact, I'm going to set an alert for next week. If it trades above 3285, 3286, I will look for a buy. It has a perfect set for a continuation higher. And the risk for this trade is going to be the low of 2.2250. And I think it looks very good. It's actually one of the best looking energy plays that I see right now. RB, and this is RBOB, this is gasoline futures. The weekly chart looks very, very weak. I think it is not ready for any kind of play just yet. It may want to retrace into these lows, into these prior lows from February, and that is the 1.65. I don't know if it should do that or not. It is not ready for a play anytime soon. The daily chart is trying to reverse, and I don't have it here on my chart, but exactly where the price is trading right now at the 1.8176, we do have the 89 simple moving average. And this may hold the price, but I don't see a good trade in heating in RBOB. And for that reason, I'm going to erase it off my hot list. Natural gas, I have received some emails in regards to natural gas. For those of you that like to trade natural gas, I'm going to, let me just erase this. All right, so natural gas has been, for the last 3 weeks, you could see it right here, it has been playing a lot of games. So a lot of indecision from these dojis because, and this week we have retested the minor support level. We didn't really come into the 3.05 and we hovered a little bit about above it. Now, next week, if we trade above 3.25, in fact, I'm gonna place a quick alert here for myself. Just to give me a heads up, we may continue back higher into the 3.4, and we might have a continuation even a bit higher than that. Let's take a look at bonds, and we're going to continue with ZB, and this is the 30-year. I had an alert here for a target level into the 140.50. I'm still going to leave it here. This is the weekly chart, and again, we've traded above the weekly chart. And if you review my video for last week, you could have seen that this was your entry for the long, the 138.25, and this right here was your stop level, and you should be looking still forward to a 140 level for a target level. Now, let's take a look at ZN, and this is the 10 year. The 10-year was a little bit more aggressive to the upside in terms of reversals, and it knocked out the first area of minor resistance, and it accelerated, and it still has room to go into the 119. So keep an eye on it if you're day trading it. It was very sideways in the trading session today, but nonetheless, it can be tradable even better off the 1 hour and off the 4 hour charts. Also, let's review silver, and this is silver and copper we have left, and here is silver. Okay, silver still has not traded, still not trading above this high of 14.885. I still have the alert from last week. This is still going to be the trigger for higher, and I think that when silver is going to be ready to rotate, then we're going to have more pressure into these metals to propel higher, if that's going to happen. Copper, the last commodity that we're going to be reviewing, the line in the sand is still going to be at 2.84. If we get a break over this area, we are definitely going to move higher with a target level into the 2.93 zone. This is all for now. I hope you have a great weekend and a great profitable week ahead, and I hope to see you in the trading room soon. Remember, if you're not a paying member, if you're not a subscriber, visit our website. It is tradeoutloud.com/live trading room. Well, we trade every day, day trade futures, and we swing trade futures and stocks. Have a good weekend, everyone, and I'll see everybody in the trading room on Monday at 9 a.m.